iFootage makes a lot of really high quality stuff, including tripods, monopods, sliders, and various other photography and videography accessories. A few weeks ago, they sent me a few items to try out, so today we're going to check out their phone holder, one of their spider crab magic arms, and also their new VS-118 suction cup, which is probably the best suction cup I've ever used. Each one of these pieces is super high quality and probably deserves their own video, but today we're going to do a quick unboxing, talk about a few of the features, and then get into some car vlogging. I guess the first item we'll take a look at is the phone holder. This is only $29. You can get a bunch of different colors, and the springs are just nice and tight. I have a pretty big iPhone. I don't know what this weighs, but this thing is heavy. Even though my phone is pretty big, it fits in here pretty snug and secure. The phone holder folds up nice and compact. It also has a nice little rubber grip for when you're throwing this thing just on a table. If you want to do a little bit of tabletop videography or photography, you can use this as a little stand. You can also rotate this 90 degrees for doing vertical video and photography. So when you're ready to mount this to a stand, all you're going to do is take the rubber cover off, and then it's got a 1/4-inch thread right here, so you can mount this to a tripod. This will also slide into various tripods without using a tripod mount. You can just slide it right in and it'll clip. I guess there's a bunch of Manfrotto style ones that this will just slide right into. If you do use the 1/4-inch mount, you can also spin this around by unlocking this, and you can rotate it 90 degrees, which is also a nice feature if you want to just pan around and film something else. It also has this nice little clip right here that gives it a little bit more support if you're on a tabletop. And I think this also lets it fit in a few different other tripod mounts. I really like this gray color. You can also get these in black and yellow. Another really cool feature is that it does have a cold shoe mount. So if you have a mobile microphone that plugs into your phone, you can go ahead and throw that right into the cold shoe and have yourself a nice little vlogging setup. And then you can use this as a compact little selfie stick. I honestly don't do much phone photography and videography because I have some really nice cameras, but I really want to get a little bit more into the mobile photography and videography stuff because of TikTok and Instagram and also YouTube Shorts. So because I'm trying to do more TikTok and YouTube Short stuff, having this nice little mobile setup with my phone and being able to do vertical video is going to be a nice little thing to have. Next, we'll look at the Spider Crab Magic Arm. This is one of their smaller versions, but everything is super high quality. You can see that it has these really big teeth on it for more strength and more security. All the quick releases have a 2-part release. In case you bump the actual lock, this still won't fall out. It's not going to drop your camera or your phone, so you're going to actually hit the safety lock too. I really like how these mounts work. It has a 3/8 male thread and then also a 1/4-inch underneath. So you don't have to worry about running adapters or anything. Most of your cameras are gonna be 1/4-inch mount. And once you just push this on and screw it in, it's just gonna screw in the 1/4-inch one. If you have something that's a 3/8 mount, you just go ahead, screw it in, and the 3/8 is right there. You don't have to worry about running reducing adapters or any of that kind of stuff. Makes everything quicker and easier. It also comes with a cold shoe mount. So if you want to use the spider crab arm for a monitor holder or a mic holder, you can go ahead and just screw this into your cold shoe mount and then throw that on top of your camera. It's a nice little addition to this whole system. For the spider crab system, you can also get ball heads and clamps and pretty much anything else you could think of. They make a longer spider crab arm that works as a slider support too, in case you need a little more support on your tripod. It's a really nice and handy system. It's not the cheapest stuff, but this is all high quality. And it looks really good too. I really love black and red. It's a good color combo. So last but definitely not least, we have the iFootage VS-118 suction cup. So on top of the suction cup, you have a 3/8 female mount, a 1/4-inch female mount, but you also have this cool little thing right here. This is gonna be either a 1/4-inch or a 3/8 male mount. You just push this, that pops out automatically, and then you have a 1/4-inch mount. If you want to use this as a 3/8, go ahead and flip this over, and then you have a 3/8 male mount on top of your suction cup. Like I said, if you don't want to use it, just press it in and it's out of the way until you do need it. There's also a 3/8 and 1/4-inch female mount on the side. You have your indicator mark here, so if this does start coming loose, this is going to pop out a little bit. You always want to keep these covered because you don't want dust getting all over your suction cup, and you don't want to scratch the surface of the suction cup. There's always a little filter on these things that you don't want to clog up, so always keep your covers on. And to mount these, all you do is put a little bit of pressure on it. You usually don't want to put suction cups on a porous surface such as a wooden table, but just to show you how good these are, we're going to go ahead and suck it to this table. Even with it a little loose, it's picking up this table, and this table's pretty heavy. This suction cup is supposed to be good for 44 pounds, just for one of these. They do make a slightly larger model that is gonna be good for 66 pounds. When I was testing this inside the car, I did give it a couple tugs on the trunk, and this did have a lot of force to it. I didn't put a weight on it and actually test for 44 pounds, but I almost think that this is more than 44 pounds, but that's what it's rated for. 44 pounds is gonna be more than your heaviest DSLR camera setup or mirrorless, and you're definitely not gonna have a phone that weighs 44 pounds. So if you're trying to do a phone rig, this is definitely gonna be more than enough. So for this test, we're gonna be using a Mustang. For those that don't know, this thing makes like 600 horsepower. It's set up for drifting. Because this thing was covered in snow earlier, everything's gonna be wet. Just to give you a quick rundown on how to attach a suction cup if you've never done one, I'm gonna show you on the trunk in a little more detail, I guess. First thing you wanna do is take your cover off. You always wanna keep this thing covered because it's soft and you don't want dirt getting all in there. You just put it on. Put a little bit of pressure down and pump this up until the grade disappears. And it says check every 4 hours, but we're just gonna have this inside the car, so we're gonna be able to see if anything starts lifting, which I doubt it will because this is a really nice suction cup. I've used a few other designs of suction cups, and this one is definitely my favorite, and it seems sturdier than most. I'm pretty sure I could use this to pull dents out of the car if I needed to. But to release the suction cup, all you do is pull from the sides where it says open. It's got these little ears. You just go ahead and pop it off. But let's go ahead and attach it to the inside of the windshield and try to do a little bit of a car vlog setup with our phone. Maybe a little bit with the camera too. Because it's so cold out, we're gonna let this thing warm up a little bit. You don't wanna rip on a car when you first start it or anything. Not that we're gonna rip on this too much. I don't like doing anything bad on the street. But tracks are gonna be closed because it's wintertime, so we're gonna give it a little bit of gas, you know? See if we can fling a phone out of the phone holder. This design of suction cup, it's pretty easy to attach with one hand. That way I can still film and talk to you guys. Always want to make sure you clean whatever surface you're putting this on. For these first test shots, we're going to be using the phone holder and the spider crab arm. The audio is going to suck a little bit more because I don't have the attachment for the Rode Wireless Go to plug into my phone. But it'll give you a good idea what you can do with a good iPhone vlog setup if you're a car vlogger. So this is going to be our first setup. You can see the suction cup, the spider crab arm, and the phone holder, and then our iPhone 12 Pro Max Plus Ultra, whatever the heck. Not the newest iPhone, but still, it's the big one, and it's the heavy one. So we're gonna drive around a little bit, shoot some clips with the phone, and see what it looks like.
With the roads near my house, they are pretty bad right now because it's winter time and everything's freezing and thawing out. Seems like the roads are just getting extra bumpy and pothole-y. So we'll see how stable this is. The iPhone settings are also really flat. It's being recorded on the 9HDR video mode. 24 frames per second at 4K, in case anybody wants to know that kind of stuff. Pretty good basic iPhone setup. And if we want, we can turn this vertical. The vertical makes me look extra wide because I'm getting fat, and also because I'm wearing two coats because I'm cold. Vertical settings will be good for anybody that's doing TikToks and also anybody that's doing YouTube shorts. And if you want to turn it back to horizontal, you can do that just by spinning the phone holder. Pretty easy. Overall, it seems pretty solid, smooth with the phone. We actually did a test the other day when it was a little bit warmer out, but I had that on the HDR phone settings and I didn't like how it looked even after color grading. And we slid around a little bit to see if the phone would actually fly out. So with doing a test the other day, I really think that this could be outside of a vehicle and the phone would be safe. I really don't want to try it because it's cold and I don't know. I just don't want to risk my phone. Honestly, if I was doing anything on the outside of a vehicle also, I would probably use a second suction cup just as a secondary support. I really feel like this is a pretty solid rig. And even how it's set up, I could take the suction cup off and use this almost as like a selfie stick with my phone. It'll be a lot more sturdy. So especially if I'm going to a car event and just want to use my phone. I can just use the suction cup and the spider crab arm as kind of a selfie stick, walk around, record, and then when I go on track, just attach it to the car. It'd be a pretty nice setup, I think. Once it gets warm out, I think we're going to do that. I really want to do more mobile stuff. Plus, it doesn't take as long to record mobile stuff. You just kind of record it and then post it, and you don't have to sit in front of the computer editing all day. As another little test, we're going to use the back-facing camera on the iPhone, which is the better camera. Currently, we're on the wide-angle setting. You can probably see a lot of the hood. Traffic died down a little bit, and we got to make a U-turn. Should be a little bit smoother, and we'll go to the regular camera angle. Sounds almost like we got a dash cam going on. Sunset looks nice though. Because the holder's spring-loaded, it almost adds a little bit of suspension to the phone. This would definitely work on the iPhone minis a lot better. I think because my phone's so dang heavy, it really is putting a little more shock on this whole system. Now we're recording with the Sony ZV-1, and the audio should be a lot better because we have the Rode Wireless Go 2 hooked up. The ZV-1 has in-camera image stabilization. It is pretty nice. The exposure could be a little bit brighter probably on my face, but I'm driving and I don't like adjusting that kind of stuff. With it being cloudy outside because the weather sucks, it's gonna make it a little bit darker too. But so far it seems pretty steady. So one thing to note, because it is one suction cup and one arm and one camera, it blocks a lot less of the road. I can see a lot more of the road. It's not really blocking my view at all. Some other suction cup mounts where you have three cups are gonna block a little bit more your windshield. But because this is kind of small and compact, it blocks a lot less. I'm not hitting potholes intentionally for this test. There's just so many of them, you can't avoid them. I'll do one small pull on the highway. Really don't want to do that because it's 40 degrees out right now and these tires suck. It's spinning bad. Overall, I'm really happy with this setup. I highly recommend it. I know it's a little bit more money than some of the arms that you can buy, but this suction cup is probably the best that I've tried. And the spider crab arm is also solid, way more solid than a lot that I've tried. And as far as phone holders, there's nothing that you can really compare it to as far as quality, at least not that I've seen. That phone holder is just solid. I'm really looking forward to using it in 2022 or whatever year that you're watching this. So thanks for hanging out with me today. I really think I'm going to be switching over to a lot of iFootage stuff soon.
So that's it for the video. I'll have links to all these items in the description below if you want to check them out for yourself. I really feel like these are the best of the best. This is the best phone holder by far. Also the best small magic arm. And the suction cup is just so strong and has so many features. It is also the best suction cup that I've used. And I've used a lot. I really want to try out more iFootage stuff. They make a really awesome monopod that I think I'm gonna buy. And they also have a full car rig that I wanna buy when I save up a couple bucks. The full car rig is a little expensive, but I feel like that's worth it too. So if you like this setup and you want a little bit more, the car rig might be the way to go. It's more expensive, but it's probably the nicest car rig that I've found. Maybe for a future video, we'll check that out. So yeah, thanks for hanging out with me today, and thanks for watching, and have a fantastic day.